Hello dear students, welcome to EPG Paathshala. I am Dr. Mandeep Kaur, Associate Professor, Khalsa College of Education, Ranjit Avenue. Well students, today we will talk about academic support structures like NUEPA, NCERT, SCERT, SIEMAT and DIET. The objectives of the topic are to explain the functions of NUEPA, to know how the academic support provided by the NCERT helps in improving the quality of education, to elucidate the objectives and functions of SCERT, to explain the academic support provided by the State Institute of Educational Management and Training. And the last one is to discuss the functions of academic support structure at the district. Starting with the topic, when Indian Constitution was enforced, education was placed in state list. But in 1976, as per the 42nd Amendment in the Constitution, education was placed in the concurrent list, which means that both center and state government can make laws on it. But if there is any conflict between the laws of center and state government, the law of center government will prevail. According to our constitution, education is a state subject and the central government plays an advisory role. The main aims of the center and state governments are to ensure relevant education for all and to universalize elementary education of satisfactory quality. But for implementation of policies and programs for the promotion of education, proper planning and management is required at different levels of education. And to achieve this goal, there is a need of academic support structures to be set up at the central level like NUEPA and NCERT, and at the state level, SCERT and SIEMAT, and DIETs at the district level. Now, student, we will discuss these structures one by one. National University of Educational Planning and Administration, NUEPA. The NUEPA is an autonomous body established by the Ministry of Human Resource Development, Government of India. It was established in the year 1962 when the UNESCO established the Asian Regional Center for Educational Planners and Administrators, which later became the Asian Institute of Educational Planning and Administration in 1965. After 4 years of its existence, it was taken by the Government of India and renamed as National Staff for Educational Planners and Administrators. In the year 1979, it was again renamed as the National Institute of Educational Planning and Administration, NIPA. It was given its present name, that is the NUEPA, in the year 2006. NUEPA deals with capacity building and research in planning and management of education, not only in India, but also in the South Asia. NUEPA provides academic support to center as well as to the state government by organizing various programs. Now, let's talk about these programs. It organizes pre-service and in-service training program in the area of educational planning and administration. It promotes and coordinates research in various aspects of educational planning and administration and allied disciplines. NUEPA provides academic and professional guidance to agencies and institutions in the field of planning and administration. It further offers PhD and MPhil courses and awards degree in education planning, finance, comparative education, school education and higher education. It also offers fellowship, scholarships and awards. It acts as a clearing house of ideas and information on research, training, extension in educational planning. It is also a house of printing and publishing papers, periodicals and books. It also publishes a journal on educational planning and administration. For educational personnel of the central and state government and unit territories, meetings, workshops, seminars are organized by it. Consultancy services in the sphere of education, planning and administration to center as well as state government universities are also provided by it. NUEPA organizes orientation and training programs and refresher courses for teacher educators and for college administrators. It initiates and encourages discussion on educational issues of national significance. It establishes contexts and advances academic collaboration with the inter-institution in India and abroad, particularly in the countries of third world. NUEPA has also developed close links with UGC, NCERT and CSIR. It confers honorary fellowship on eminent educationists for continuation in the field of educational planning and administration. It disseminates information regarding new advances, symbolic links between the imparting and generation of knowledge are built by this structure. It also strengthens basic and applied research in the sphere of educational planning and administration. Next academic support structure is National Council of Educational Research and Training, NCERT. NCERT, another apex resource organization set up by the Government of India. It is an autonomous organization which was established on September 1, 1961 with its headquarters at New Delhi. It is registered under the Societies Registration Act 1960 and functions as the academic advisor to the Ministry of Education and Social Welfare. The Union Ministry for Education and Youth Services are the president of the general body of the council. The administration of NCERT is in the hands of executive committee. As shown in the flowchart, NCERT functions through various constituents units like National Institute of Education, NIE, Central Institute of Educational Technology, CIET, 5 regional colleges of education at Ajmer, Bhopal, Bhubaneswar, Mysore and Shillong, and the last unit is Pandit Sundala Sharma, Central Institute of Vocational Education. With a view to improve the quality of school education in India, NCERT provides the support in many ways. Now, let's have a look how NCERT does this. It determines the aims of school education. It prepares school model curriculum and textbooks for different levels of school education. It determines the aims of training of school teachers. It prepares the curriculum for the training of teachers at different levels. Pre-service and in-service training, mostly at advanced level, is organized by NCERT. NCERT performs new experiments in the field of education. It makes efforts for the expansion and upliftment of secondary education. For bringing improvement in the field of education, it undertakes, promotes, aids and coordinates research in all branches of education. It organizes extension services in educational institutions. It undertakes studies, investigations and surveys relating to the educational matter on the assessment of educational programs. It establishes coordination with the state level institutions and implements policies and programs relating to educational reforms. Not only at the state level, it also has established coordination with the organizations at international level like UNESCO and UNICEF. Training and research facilities to the educationist and persons associated with the education at different levels are provided by it. It assists and advises the center and the state government on academic matters related to school education. In order to identify talented students, National Talent Search programs at national and state level is organized by it. To evaluate development of education, it organizes survey at national level after every 5 years. It disseminates improved techniques and practices and acts as a clearing house for ideas and information on all matters relating to school education. In order to carry out its functions effectively, NCERT works in close cooperation with the education departments in the states, and it has a network of offices of field advisors in different states. It also maintains a close link with the universities and generally with all the institutions set up in the country for furthering the objectives of school education. It publishes journal, research reports, teachers' guides, and other useful material for the benefits of teachers, students, research workers, and other persons associated with the education. Some of the well-known journals and magazines published by NCERT are Indian Educational Review, the Journal of Indian Education, School Science, Primary Teacher. Moving ahead to next port is State Council of Educational Research and Training, that is SCERT. SCERT is in fact a counterpart of NCERT in the state. It has been given the responsibility of overseeing the work done in the academic wing of the School Education Board in the area of curriculum, renewal and development of textbooks. Objectives behind State Council of Educational Research and Training are to bring qualitative improvement in the existing education system, to develop the curriculum of various school subjects, to provide pre-service and in-service education for teachers and educational supervisors, to develop new techniques and methodologies in the field of school education, to undertake and promote investigation, surveys, studies and researches in the various fields and sections of education, to formulate and implement pilot projects for bringing about quality improvement in different fields of school education, to evaluate, monitor and develop educational programs, to provide career guidance and counseling to school students, to introduce new policies of center and state level. Beside these objectives, SCERT provides major support to promote education at state level. It does this by arranging in-service training for teacher educators, working in teacher training institutions for all stages of education, that is from preschool to secondary stage, arranging in-service training and orientation for supervisory and inspecting officers dealing with preschool, elementary, secondary and senior secondary education in the state, providing extension services to teacher training institutions at all levels, coordinating the work of extension centers of teachers training institution in the state, organizing correspondence cum contact course for overall professional development of teachers, teacher educators, supervisory and inspecting officer, preparing curriculum instructional material, textbooks for all levels of education for the use of educational institutions and teachers in the state, prescribing textbooks for school and teacher training institution at the preschool and elementary stage, coordinating the programs of different subject teachers associations in the state, functioning as a controlling authority essentially in connection with academic aspects of elementary teachers education, and if possible in connection with its administrative aspects also, conducting research at preschool, elementary, secondary and senior secondary education levels, acting as agent of change in school education and lifelong non-formal education in general and in teacher education in particular. SCERT perform all the above said functions through the major three units, that as shown in the flowchart: Department of Curriculum Development, Department of Training and Extension, and last one is Department of Education Technology. These three departments are further divided into many subunits so as to disseminate the work properly and to achieve the above set objectives. Now, State Institute of Educational Management and Training, that is SIEMAT. CMAT is an institute designed to develop the capacity of all categories of administrative and field functionaries down to the village levels to efficiently manage educational institutions and to provide the professional support required by them in the context of SSA, Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan. Talking about the aims and objectives of CMAT, number one is to ensure school effectiveness through the development of local level and school level management capacities, to provide resources support in the area of planning and management to the field functionaries like district project coordinators, DPCs, SDOs, chief executive officer, CEOs, coordinators, block level resource persons, members of village education committees, VECs, headmasters of elementary school, faculty members of DIETs, districts, sub-district projects, officer of SSA and SCERT faculty members. To establish linkage with agencies and institutions of both government and non-government which are engaged in various welfare programs and education. To strengthen educational database for decentralized planning and management, to give advice and guidance to various levels of functionaries in planning and management for education if and when necessary, to undertake case studies, research activities pertaining to educational management and school organization and problems relating to school. Now, let's discuss about academic support provided by CMAT. The organization structure of the CMAT may be related to its expected role, but the specific requirement may vary from state to state. Some of the functions of the CMAT are, it provides support to policy planning at the state level. This can be facilitated through providing an advisory supportive role to the state government through conducting research in areas of concern for policy making and implementation at the state level and organizing orientation programs for senior level educational administrators at the state level. For example, issue like evolving norms regarding setting up of educational institutions, recruitments and posting of teachers, provision of infrastructure facilities in educational institutions and performance of educational institutions. The institute may conduct research studies on various aspects including evaluation research of various programs initiated by the state government to assess the relative effectiveness of various schemes including the incentive scheme. Organizing training programs for educational functionaries at the district and sub-district level on various aspects related to the educational planning and management and organizing seminars in the areas of concerns. Next one is developing local level capacity for undertaking school mapping exercise, micro planning activities and facilitating participatory process of educational planning and management in association with the lower level administrative academic bodies. Improving competences of the advisory staff to improve the efficiency of the educational institution and the system as a whole. Providing support in the handling of data pertaining to various indicators of the educational development on which performance of the district or the school can be assessed. Developing competences for costing of educational plans and mobilization and utilization of resources including preparation of budgets, project planning and implementation including monitoring and evaluation of projects, providing professional guidance to sub-state level institutions dealing with the educational planning and management. Next one is conducting programs which could ensure enrollment, retention and learning achievement of the elementary school children through district, cluster and village-based strategies. Motivation and sensitization of functionaries as required for the various steps of UEA. In other words, the institution may be playing an advisory and policy support role at the state level, conducting direct and indirect training programs for educational functionaries and conducting research in various aspects related to educational policy and program. Moving towards the academic support provided at district level, DIETs. District Institute of Education and Training. The agency which is responsible for providing pre-service, in-service education to elementary school teachers, non-formal and adult education is DIET. The program of action in the year 1992, which is a follow-up program of National Policy of Education 1986, is in view of giving the central place to teacher education. NPE calls for its overhaul as the first step towards educational recognition. In 1987-88, a centrally sponsored scheme for restructuring and reorganization of teacher education was started, which including setting up of DIETs. Between 1987-88 and 1991-92, central assistant was extended to set up 287 DIETs. DIET is the third district level support system for the qualitative improvement of education. In addition to national and state level agencies like NCERT, NUEPA and SCERT, it also caters to qualitative improvement as the teachers are closer to the field and thus more sensitive to their problems and needs. The mission of DIET is to provide academic and resource support at the grassroots level for the success of various strategies and programs being undertaken in the area of elementary and adult education, with special reference to universalization of elementary education. And the next one is National Literacy Mission, target in regards to functional literacy for the age group of 15 to 35 years. Talking about special target group of DIETs, which are elementary school teachers, both pre-service and in-service, headmasters, head of school complexes, education officers, instructors, supervisors for non-formal and adult education, members of district board of education DBEs and village education committees VECs, community teachers, youth and other volunteers, resource persons who will conduct suitable programs for the target groups, that is the girls and women, SC, ST minorities and handicapped and other educationally disadvantaged groups like working children, slum dwellers, inhabitants of hilly areas. Now, talking about academic support provided by DIETs to transfer the present system of elementary education are, number one is to provide pre-service and in-service education to primary school teacher, to provide induction education and continue education to instructors and supervisor for non-formal adult education courses and programs, to provide training and orientation to the heads of the institution in institutional planning and management at macro level, to give orientation to community leaders, functionaries of voluntary organization and others who influence school education, to give academic support, consultancy and counseling services to DBEs, to undertake action research and experiments for removing local level educational problems and ills. Next one is to serve as evaluation centers for primary and upper primary school as well as for non-formal and adult education centers, to act as resource centers for teacher and instructors, to coordinate with VECs, DBES, SCERT, NCERT, NUEPA, CTEs and CASEs. In view of the new thrust given by Ramamurthy Committee Report 1990, DIETs would have to undertake fresh responsibilities and develop competencies in certain areas like universalization of elementary education, UEE, early childhood care and education, ECCE, women's education with emphasis on giving a gender perspective to the entire educational process, education for promoting equity and social justice among SCs and STs and other educational backward sections of society including minorities. Next is vocationalization of the entire educational process, examination reforms, multiple entry and exit points. In order to effectively carry out its function, the DIET have 7 branches: pre-service teacher education, PSTE, work experience branch, WE, district resource unit, for adult and non-formal education. In service program, field, interaction and innovation coordination, IFIC, curriculum material development and evaluation, CMDE, educational technology, ET, and the last one is planning and management. From the above discussion, it is clear that DIET in each district is an encouraging step for achieving universalization of elementary education and improving the quality of education in school. The important task is to make DIETs operationally by executing its programs sincerely, procuring equipment and recruiting capable personnel. By doing so, a more balanced qualitative and quantitative development of elementary education across the nation will soon be realized. Student, this is all about the how the academic support structure play important role in the bringing qualitative change in the field of education. Now, let's have quick review. What we have studied for the promotion of education in the country, there's need to establish central and state level academic support structures, which should work collectively for the improvement of education. Academic support structures at central level like NUEPA and NCERT and state level like SCERT, SIEMAT and DIET at district level are developed with the aim to implement all the educational policies and programs regarding promotion of education throughout the country. Thank you.